Hello everyone, this is Rahul Malhotra from SFDC Stop, and in this video we are going to learn about that how you can update and save records through your Lightning components in Salesforce. In our last tutorial we mainly learned about that how we can fetch and display data from the Salesforce server to our Lightning component. And this is the second video in the Salesforce Lightning tutorial series in which we are going to move a step further and we will learn about how we can update and save the records. So, in our last video, we made a Lightning application which display various contacts, and we also added a new button using which we can create a new contact. And finally, we embedded our Lightning component under an account detail page so that when I click on new contact, we can create a new contact related to that account. So now we are going to move a step further and we are going to add an edit button in here so that we can edit our contacts and we can update our contacts. So let's start coding. First of all, I will work on our component so that we can view the changes. So before going to our component, I want to make some small changes in my Apex controller. So my Apex controller name is my contacts controller. So in this controller, as you can see that I have an SQL query in which I am fetching the ID, name, account ID, phone and email from contact. So I am going to do a small changes in here that I am going to add first name and last name. So up till now we were only displaying the name of the contact, but now we have to edit the contact also. So we need two different fields, first name and last name, so that it can be, the contact name can be easily edited and saved. So I am going to save this change here. And now I am going towards my contact component. So this component mainly consists of the record view form, and now I'm going to add a edit form also in this component. So to add an edit form, I'm going to use aura iteration again. So let's add another aura iteration. Items will be same. That is v.contactList, and variable will be also same, contact. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to display an edit form here so that I can edit the records that are displayed. So within our aura iteration, I'm going to make a box. So to add a box, I will again make a div with the same class as above, that is slds-box, then slds-theme_default. And within this div, I am going to use lightning input tag to display an input field, and I am going to use value, which is my contact.firstname. So this is my first name input field, and similarly I am going to make four input fields, one for last name, one for phone and one for email. So my next name field is for last name, and my next input field is for contact.phone, and my next input field is for contact.email. Let's consider it as email and then phone. So this, by default Lightning input field has a type of text, so I'm using email here, so it has a type of email, and I'm using phone here, so it has a type of telephone. And above here also I'm going to make some changes. First is the first name, and then I'm going to display last name. Well, I can display name here also, but I have made some changes in my controller and I'm going to fetch first name and last name. So if I don't want to make any change here in the display component, then I have to fetch the name also from SOQL. Otherwise I can make it first name and last name respectively. And during the editing phase, I have to make first name and last name because I can't take the name combined, and I have to take the first name and last name separately so that I can save the contact. Okay, so let's see how our component looks like. So this is my component. My two contacts are displayed here, and this is my edit form in which first name, last name, and then email and then phone number is displayed. Okay, so let's see what we can do now. So our, in case of our email, there is automatically a validation that you have entered an invalid format because I have specified type is equal to email in my component. But in case of telephone, we have to specify that which format of telephone number it will accept. So using to specify the format, I'm going to add a regex pattern. A regex pattern is mainly a regular expression. Regex is mainly a regular expression. So I'm going to specify a regular expression for my telephone, that how, which type of values it will accept. So I can see that my telephones are usually, numbers are mainly with brackets, then three letters, and then a space, then three numbers, and then a hyphen, and then four numbers. So I'm going to add the same. Let's add a pattern here. The regex is defined by pattern, and then I want to have a bracket, and that bracket will be ignored, so I'm adding a forward slash to that. And then I'm going to add numbers from 0 to 9. And the quantity of these numbers is 3. And then I'm going to add a closing bracket. After this, I'm going to add 0 to 9 again. And I'm going to add 3 numbers again. So as you can see here, I have bracket, then 3 numbers, then bracket close, then a space, then 3 numbers again. So bracket, then 0 to 9, 3 numbers, then bracket close, then space, then 3 numbers again with 0 to 9. And then I'm going to add a hyphen. And then I'm going to add 0 to 9 and 4 numbers respectively. So this is my pattern for telephone. Let's check whether it is working or not. So I'm going to save my component. I'm going to refresh my page. And if I have 3 numbers in here, then yes, it is working. That your entry doesn't match the criteria. And if I'm going to remove the bracket also, then it is also working. So this is how you can add a validation. This is mainly for client-side validation, so that you can specify the error if the format is not particularly correct. Okay, so let's move further. We have our display page, we have our edit component. So now we need a button in our component. So let's move on to action buttons first. So I'm going to move on to action buttons, and I'm going to add a component, a lightning button in here mainly. So the lightning button, its label will be edit. And I'm going to add a variant in this button, and variant will be brand. So I'm going to give a variant brand because it is blue in color mainly. So now I give a name, and name will be edit. And then on click, I will call a function namely edit contact. So I'm going to save this. And one last thing that I want to add is I want to wrap my both iterations in wrapper divs. So I'm going to wrap a div or iteration in div here, and its or ID is going to be record view form, and I'm going to close this div below my aura iteration, and I'm going to add again a wrapper div with aura ID is equal to record edit form, and I'm going to close this div at the end of aura iteration. So why I have added these wrapper divs, the reason is that because I want to display only one form at a time. Either we have to view the records or I have to edit the records. So that's why I have added a wrapper div in here. So let's see how much we have done till now. So I'm going to update the preview. So okay, now I have my edit button and I have added a brand, a variant which is equal to brand. So I have my button in blue color. So and I have both my components, the view component as well as the edit component. But when I'm loading the page initially, I only want to display my record. I don't want to see the edit form. So I'm going to add a class here, and a class name is basically let's say form height, because it is going to hide my form. So in this class, I'm going to add this class in style. Let's define this class as form height. And what I'm going to add in here, I'm going to add the property of display to none. So this is my class. So this is my CSS form hide with display none. Let's see whether it is working or not. I'm going to refresh this page again. And now I have only my record view component and not the record edit part. So okay, my record view component is there. Now what I want, then when I click on this edit button, then my record view component is gone, and it will show my record edit component so that I can edit the record. And when I'm editing the record, then this edit button should also be changed to save button so that I can save the record. So I have done my part in my component. Let's move on to controller now. So in controller, I have two functions right now. One is for getting the contact and another is for making a new contact. So I'm going to add another function below here, and I'm going to name it as edit contacts. As I am going to call this function using my button, and it should be edit contacts. Okay, so in edit contacts function, what I'm going to do, let's define a function first, component, then event, then helper. So in this function, I'm going to first take the reference of button, where button is equal to event dot get source. So what this will do, it will give me the reference to the button. As I will click on this button and my function is called, so when I go to event dot get source, then it will give me the reference to that particular button. So what I'm going to, why I'm taking this reference, because I need whether the button is edit or save. So I have added two attributes to my button. First is the name and second is the label. So I'm going to use this both. So let's check what is the value in the name attribute of the button. So where name is equal to btn dot get and then b dot name. So what I want is now if my name is edit, that is if my button is displaying the edit, then I have to do another job, and else if my name is save, if my button is a save button, then I have to click, then I have to call the function of helper, namely save context, and I will pass component, event and helper in here. So if my button is a save button, then I have made the changes and I will call the helper function with save context, and it will consist of component, event and helper. And if my button is the edit button, which it is actually in initial stage, then what I'm going to do, I'm going to hide the display form and I'm going to show the edit form. So I need the references to both the forms. So to take the reference to both the form, I'm going to take the reference using the Aura ID. That's why I have wrapped it in div. So my view form Aura ID is record view form, and edit form Aura ID is record edit form. So let's take the reference to both. So how can I find any div or any element in my Lightning component using Aura ID? So I'm going to say where record view form is equal to component dot, I'm going to find that particular error Aura ID, that is record view form. So this will give my components, my record view form div reference to this variable, and I'm going to add where record edit form similarly is equal to component dot find v dot record edit form. So I have added the references to my record view form and record edit form also. So once the button has a name of edit, now what I have to do, I have to, as you know that I have made a form hide class which will hide the section. So what I have to do, I have to hide the record view form and I have to show the record edit form. And initially my record view form is not associated with any class, whereas my record edit form has a class of form hide. So I'm going to remove the class from here and I'm going to add the class here. So how can I do this? To do this action, I'm going to call $a.util.addClass, and the component in which I'm going to add this class is recordViewForm, and the class that I'm going to add is FormHide, and I'm going to remove the class from recordEditForm. So $a dot util dot remove class record edit form and form hide. So I'm going to add the class to my record view form, and the class name is form hide, and I'm going to remove the class from my record edit form, and the class name is form hide. So what does $a dot util signifies? $a is mainly, let me show you the doc first. I have the Aura documentation. $a is mainly the global instance, and what I'm going to use, I'm going to use a util class which is available, and it consists of various methods like add class, remove class, toggle class that I'm using. So I'm going to use the add class and remove class method that will add, that will take an element and a class, and I will add the class to that particular element. So I have a reference to my elements, and I'm going to add a class and remove class using the util class that is present in our $a reference, which is mainly our global instance. So I have added a class and I have removed a class, so it should work right now. Let's see whether it is working or not. So I'm going to refresh my component, and when I click my edit button, then this should remove and my edit form should display. Okay, so on clicking my edit button, the form is removed but my edit form is not there. So let's see what's the error here that I'm going to record view form, record edit form, go class form height and add class form height. Okay, record edit form. Record edit form. Form height. Okay, so here is the error. I have added v.recordEditForm, whereas I have to give only the record aura ID in component.find and not a reference using v. or something. So let's check it again. When I'm going to click edit, my this form will vanish and my edit form will display. So okay, that's working now. My this form is vanished and my edit form is displayed. But my edit button is still edit. So I want this button to be named as save. So I'm going to add further functions. I have a reference to my button using btn. So I can set. So I'm going to set button dot set. Which property I have to set? I have to set the name attribute to save. And I have to set the label attribute also to save. I'm setting the name attribute because I'm referencing my button, or I'm making decisions based on my name attribute, and the label is what is displayed actually. So I'm going to label it as save. So let's see once again whether the changes are working or not. Okay, my edit component, edit button is there, my component is there. Once I click on edit, okay, so unable to set value for key name. Okay, I have to add v.name here because I'm using the set method, and v.label because I'm using the get and set method. While using get and set method, I have to use v.name and v.label, and in component.find I have to only get the aura ID. So let's check once again. Edit, and yes, my button has a label of save now. So okay, now I have my edit form label and I have my save button, and when I click on save, I'm going to call a helper method which is save contacts. So let's create one helper method now. Right now my helper has only one method, that is fetch contacts. So I'm going to create another method here, namely save contacts. So what this function is going to do, it is going to fetch a list of contacts from my contact list that is here, and as you can see that I have a single attribute named contact list, and this attribute is passed to both the record view form as well as the record edit form. So this is the beauty of Lightning, that if I make any changes in here in first name or last name, then the changes are automatically reflected in the contact list, and I can simply take this contact list using component.get. And I can pass that contact list to my FS controller, and simply my list is updated. So let's make our FS controller changes first, because I have to save the contacts, so I have to add another method in here to save the contacts. So let's add another method in here, or enabled. I am going to return a map of string from this method. So public static map of string, and my method name is save contact list, and list, it will take a list of contact as a parameter, and let's name it as contact list. Okay, so here is my method. It is returning a string map, and its name is save contact list, and it is going to take contact list as a parameter. So what my method is going to do, it is going to update the contact list let us pass through it. But what if any exception is there while updating? So I have to add a try catch, and I will push this update in the try, and in the catch I have to catch an exception. So I have taken, and I am returning a map of string to return a proper error response. A map is simply, if you don't know what the map is, it's simply a key value pair where you can give a key and you can give a particular value to that. So I am going to make a map that has a key of string type as well as value of string type, and I'm going to name it as result map, and I'm going to add new map. Then it has a key of string and a value of string also. Okay, let's see. Result map. And now if my contact list is updated successfully, then I'm going to take two keys now, one for success or failure message and the next key for the message that I'm going to pass. So result map dot put. So my key is status and my value here is, if there is no exception, then it will go down here, and my value here is success. And next is result map dot put. My next key is message and my value here is, let's say, data saved. Or I should say, I think contacts updated successfully. Contacts updated successfully. Okay. So this is my result map. In case my updation is done perfectly, if there is any error, that I'm going to add a result map in which my status is error and my message will be the message which is coming from the exception. So I have a method named e.getMessage which is returning my string. So I'm going to add a message with e.getMessage. So at the end I'm going to return result map. So let's save this. So my apps controller is ready. What it is doing, it is taking a list of contact as a parameter, and it is making a map which is of type key value pair, which is of string and string, and it is going to update the contact list, and if there is an exception, then it is going to put the status as error and message as e.getMessage, which is the exception message. And if the update is successfully done, then it is going to put the status as success and message as contacts updated successfully, and finally it is going to return the result map. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to call this Apex controller using the save context helper. So let's start making our helper now. So in my helper, I'm going to first of all define an action, and I'm going to fetch contact list. So where contact list is equal to component dot get v dot contact list, and I have my contact list now. So what I'm going to do, so I have my contact list, and in next line I'm going to get a reference to view form and edit form, because if my contacts are saved, then I have to display the view form and I have to hide the edit form again. So I need references to both. So record view form is equal to component.find record view form, and where record edit form is equal to component dot find record edit form. So I have my references to view form and edit form, and now what I'm going to add, I'm going to add an action where save action is equal to component.get, and I'm going to call the action that is defined, that is the function of my FX controller, save contact list. So I'm going to add component.get FX controller save contact list. So now I'm going to add parameters. So save action dot set params. It is the same as we have done in case of read. So save action dot set params. And what is my parameter? My parameter here is contact list. Contact list, and it is going to have the contact list variable that I have here. So it is going to pass a list of contacts in my action, that is in my Apex controller function. And finally I have to add a callback function. So save action dot set callback. This function response, and I'm going to add $a dot nq action save action. So save action dot set callback, this function response, and now I'm going to check whether the callback is done and whether the state is correct or not. So as state is equal to response dot get state, and if my state is equal to success, then what I'm going to do, if my state is success, then this means that my data is saved successfully and I have a response maybe. And if my state is not success, then I am going to add a simple alert that I am having an error in getting data. So if my state is success, now what I want is I want to get my response. Okay, so where data map, because my response is a map, so I'm taking the variable name as map here. Data map is equal to response dot get return value. So this is my data map, and now what I want is if data map has a status. Because data map has two keys, one is the status and second is the message. So I'm checking if the status is perfect, that is there is no exception, is equal to success, then I'm going to do something, and else if data map dot status is equal to error, then I'm going to do something. So what I'm going to do in case of success, I'm going to again set the button to edit, and I'm going to hide the form, and I'm going to show the save form, the record view form. So what I'm going to do is I will take the same code like in controller. I have edit class, util class, button. So I'm going to just copy and paste this code here, and I have to make the necessary changes, because if my data is saved successfully, then I have to hide the record edit form and I have to show the record view form. So I will remove the class from here, and I have to set the button name as edit again and my button label as edit again. So I'm going to do this. And what if my state is error? Then I'm going to show an error message. So in case of success, I'm going to show a success message, and in case of error, I have to show an error message. So I'm going to introduce a new component here, that is Lightning inbuilt component, that also run in one app container, as I have discussed in my previous tutorial that in one app container, so that it will not run in here but it will run here. As you can see that new button is not working here, but it will run in the one app container, because the one app container is mainly when it is embedded somewhere and the URL has one app, in simple words. So it will run in one app container. What I'm going to add, I'm going to add a toast. So let's define a toast first. So to define a toast event, so I'm going to define a toast event in here, where toast event is equal to $a. It is also a global event, so $a dot get e dot force colon show toast. So this is my toast event. So in case of success, what I'm going to do, I'm going to set some parameters. So toast event dot set params, and in case of set params, I'm going to add a title. That is, what is the title of my toast? My title of toast is success. And what is the type of toast? Which type of toast is there? So is it a success toast or it is an error toast? So the type is success. And next is, what is my mode of toast? So toast can be dismissible or non-dismissible. So I'm going to add a dismissible toast here. So dismissible toast mainly means that it will dismiss automatically after a timeout, or if you click on the cross button, it will dismiss. And I have to add a message to my toast. Last, I have to add a message to my toast. So my message to toast is, context updated successfully. Context, actually I can take the message directly from my response. My response is data map dot message, and I'm going to fire this toast finally. So I have to add toast event dot fire. And what in case of error? In case of error, I have to set different parameters and I have to fire the toast again. So I'm going to add some different parameters. In this case, my title is error. My type is also error. Mode is same dismissible, and message is same data map dot message, because in case of error, my message will be different. So this is a, and then I'm going to fire the toast event. So what this toast event is going to show? It is going to show a simple toast, that whether my data is saved or not. So let's try our component now. All our work is done. I have made a helper, I have made a controller, and it's time to try our component now. So let's try our component. Okay, now I'm going to click the edit form. Okay, let's refresh it once. I'm going to click the edit form, and it should show the edit form. Okay, fine. I'm going to make some changes, like add D1 and Rahul1, and I'm going to save it. Okay, so my toast is not working, as I'm not in the one app container, but it's fine. And it is showing the context again. And if I refresh my component, then my changes are there, D1 and Rahul1. So let's embed it in this, because it is already embedded, I think. Yeah, I have already embedded this component in my account detail page, so it should show the changes. Let's see how it is working in the one app container now. Okay, so it's in cache. I have to refresh it again. Okay, my edit button is there. Now I'm going to remove Andy1 and Rahul1. I'm going to save this component. Okay, so there is an error in get callback save contact list. Button is not defined. Okay, so let's check whether button is defined or not. Save contact and button dot set, and where I have defined the button. Okay, I haven't defined the button yet. So I forgot to define the button, And in case of button, I'm going to simply call button.getSource. Okay, so I have defined the button now. Let's try it once again. Come on. Okay, so I have to make the changes once again. Andy 1 and Malhotra 1, let's say this time. I'm going to save it. It's in cache, sorry. So there is a problem of cache with Lightning also, that you have to refresh it again in case there is a cache. So let's refresh it once again just to be sure. So okay, I have refreshed my component now. So I'm going to make changes again. I'm going to remove one from here and Malhotra one from here, and I'm going to save this. Okay, so here is my toast success, context has updated successfully, and my display component is again there. And if I click on edit again, then I have my edit component. And my changes are already done here. So if I refresh my component, it will automatically show the changes that I made. I have removed one from Andy and from Malhotra. So these changes are done in my context. So this is how you can make a Lightning component, and you can edit the data and you can save the changes simply. And it usually seems to be difficult that you have to use the same button for editing and for saving also, and you have to replace this form with the edit form, but it is so simple, you can see. With a little amount of code, we have done it easily. So I have added all the description in my blog. You can visit it if you want to read step by step everything. And for any other thing, you can visit my GitHub repository, and I have added the latest code to update branch mainly. So in my GitHub repository, SFDC Lightning, just jump onto the update branch, because I'm going to update the master branch in my other videos that I'm going to update in future. So go to the update branch and you have all the code in here that is related to this particular video. So okay, thanks for watching guys. I hope you liked this video, and if you have any kind of suggestions, any comments, then please give it in the comment section of the YouTube video, or you can message me personally also. So thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video also. And in the next video, we will mainly learn about I think deleting a record from the Lightning component, or adding validations, that is server side validations, using which we can validate whether our data is correct or not. So okay, thanks for watching guys, have a good day, bye.